everyone, finally at the end of this episode, all the truth is revealed. Suji has evidence that the first genetic test sample was not Uri's sample but Nayeong's. Then Suji also has evidence that 25 years ago, Jin-tae had met Uri but Jin-tae ignored Uri. And when Jin-tae wanted to defend himself, Hyun-seung stopped Jin-tae. He stopped Jin-tae from hiding the truth any longer because the evidence had been revealed. He also told Jin-tae to tell Suji all the truth. At the same time, it turned out that Uri heard all their conversation from outside Jin-tae's room. Then he entered Jin-tae's room because he was very shocked by what he had just heard. In the preview of the next episode, it was shown that Hyun-seung also had a recording of Nayeong's voice where Nayeong admitted that she did everything Jin-tae told her. It seems that Hyun-seung listened to Nayeong's voice recording to Kim Mari so that Nayeong could not make excuses or lie anymore to save herself. Then that night, Nayeong was kicked out of the Han family house. Once again, Nayeong blamed Suji for what happened to her. She said, "This is all because of you. You came into my life and ruined it all again." Then there is also Jin-tae, who wrote a letter to Kim Mari. The first sentence in the letter, Jin-tae said, "Kim Mari, it is time for me to reveal the truth that I find difficult to say with my own mouth." Then after writing the letter, Jin-tae disappeared. He left the house and also the hospital. At the end of this preview, Kim Mari lay weak after knowing all the truth and she screamed saying Jin-tae's name. Okay everyone, that's the preview this time. Thank you for watching my video.